Good afternoon all for the afternoon session. So we were into the topic of production of nanosensors. So depending upon the bioreceptors, you can select nanoparticles, which you can use it, which mixes with that, and the transducer gives you a signal amplification and reduction. So this is the basic design and working of this nanosensor. So just wanted to share a small animated video on this. Okay.
Molecules to super products. Final production made possible by a challenge grant from Mark Sims and Nanorex Incorporated. Future advances in molecular nanotechnology will enable desktop appliances to manufacture products far better than today's best. The cartridges to the left supply simple raw materials to the machinery inside, here shown in schematic form. Products emerge from the top of this box, which holds the heart of the manufacturing system. Each product is built from beneath, layer by layer, by billions of tiny machines all working together. Near the top surface is the productive machinery itself, organized into layers. Machines in the lowest layer process molecules into building blocks, passing them upward to machines that assemble them into larger components, and then to machines that add these components to the product. From a millimeter scale, 1 million nanometers, our view zooms in to the 10 nanometer scale. Each box is 1/10 the size of the one before. Here, at the molecular scale, nanomachines make small building blocks from molecular raw materials. The first machines sort molecules by their size and shape, passing some, rejecting others. Only molecules of the right kind can enter the processing machinery. These molecules contain four atoms, two of carbon and two of hydrogen. The molecules bind to a device that carries them to the next stage. Then, a rotating mechanism swings tool tips into contact with the bound molecules. Each tip presses a molecular tool against a molecule, bonding it firmly. The tools shown here have been analyzed using advanced quantum chemistry techniques. Another tool moves in from the left to remove the hydrogen atoms, leaving a pair of carbon atoms exposed and ready to use. The tools then carry these atoms to their destination, where each pair bonds to a nanoscale building block, making a tiny bit of crystalline carbon, a bit of diamond. Motions happen quickly at this scale. This scene shows motion slowed by a factor of more than a million. A conveyor carries the blocks past further machines, which build the blocks, step by step, to full size. Elsewhere, other specialized machines build blocks of different kinds. A system of conveyor belts and transfer mechanisms carries completed blocks from where they are made to where they are needed. This transfer mechanism moves blocks from one belt to another. The transportation system carries many different kinds of blocks, different shapes, different materials, different functions. It delivers them to the next stage of manufacturing. Here, a programmable machine lifts and places small blocks to make larger blocks. The small blocks bond on contact to form components containing millions of precisely arranged atoms. These can be simple structural bricks or intricate components for mechanical and electronic systems. The completed components are delivered to the final assembly stage, where many machines work together to build the final product. Motions at this larger scale are still quick. This scene shows motion slowed by a factor of 10,000. At the base of each machine, a transfer mechanism grabs components and lifts them from a conveyor. Each is flipped around, then carried up to the underside of the product under construction. Finally, machines lift the components and plug them in place, adding layer after layer to the bottom of the product. When the last layer is finished and construction is complete, the product is ready to be removed and used. The result of this production run is an atomically precise multiprocessor laptop computer with a billion times more processing power than today's best. The only waste products are warm air and pure water.
Animation. So it is such a big interesting, just think about manufacturing a nano sensor, nanoparticles, a nano device will be more we need more accuracy, precision and things to manufacture that. So generally in this talking about a production, as I told you, top-down methods or commonly we call lithography we use. One more technology what they do in manufacturing nano is fiber pulling. So normally this fiber pulling technology is used for optical fiber development, especially in nano sensors. So the method of it is like a tension device to stretch the major axis of fiber while heating to achieve nano sized scale. And this method specially used in optical fiber to develop optical fiber based nano sensors. So that is one more manufacturing technology that is called fiber pulling. And next is chemical etching process. So here two different types of chemicals etching can be done, like hydrofluoric acid. You can use it in a chemical etching process. And hydrogen fluoride they use, and silica fibers which is surrounding that as a cladding, and capillary action is also used in that. So as when silica fiber and this chemicals are etched away, the polymer cladding acts as a wall, and it will creating microcurrents in the hydrofluoric acid which is coupled with the capillary action. So it will cause that fiber to be etched into the space of cone with larger or smooth tappers. So this is also called as Turner method. So that is also one method. So in other we discussed was bottom up method. So in that atoms, which is or molecules which is converted into nanoparticle. So there we use self assembly, which we saw. So next, coming into next this one, nanomaterials comprise metal nanoparticles, metal nano clusters, metal oxide nanoparticles. Metal and carbon quantum dots. Quantum dots are also very much used in research, and graphene. Graphene is very much used related to our sensing in nano sensors. Maybe I have the slides, we'll see, which we use nowadays, the body trackers and all. Carbon nanotubes, where mechanically we use a lot in research, and nanocomposites. Getting up much developed, just like our composite materials what normally we do, nanocomposites are also getting very high development. And sensors include electrochemicals in nano sensors, optical nano sensors, electronic nose and electronic tongue, nano barcode technology, and wireless nano sensors. So many variety, and depends upon the application, we have different types. The sensitivity of this sensors is due to the unique electrochemical, optical, Raman, you know that Raman effect, we have studied long back, catalytic and super paramagnetic properties. So this gives the sensitivity to the nanosensors, which gives more better values. They can detect food contaminants such as preservatives, antibiotics, heavy metal ions, toxinics, microbial load, and pathogens. They can also monitor temperature, traceability, humidity, gas, and aroma of foodstuff. Even in many cases, for safety purpose, we have nano gas sensors, which you can use it. So approximately a nanoparticle looks like this. So the structure which you are seeing. So in that we have organic nanoparticles and inorganic nanoparticles. So a few of them are shown here. So nanoparticles, organic ones, which are shown at the top, and inorganic ones, which is made with metal and things. So as we first, when we started about nanotechnology and things, we saw that they gave a, but nanoparticles are freely available in nature also, and it is also manufactured. So inorganic nanoparticles, normally we manufacture organic particles we have. So depending upon the application and things, we can use the nanoparticles to making nano products, nanotechnology. The other form, the same thing, other form of nanoparticles. So even the shape and things or symbols, the particles will be like this. This is a nanoparticle, different shapes with gold. So nanoparticles, according to the required one, we can design. Because when we talk about nanoparticle, like virus, is it with a particular shape? No, it depends upon your design. So nanoparticle will be so small that even you cannot see in the eyes. We know that now. But there is a question, like virus, we cannot see the virus, but they give a shape for the virus and tell this is the shape. So like that, nanoparticles, it depends upon the design requirement. And some type of metal nanoparticles used. So AUAG, NI, COPT. So you can just go through this. There are a number of, and here where more study is going on in nanoparticles, which all we can use and which we have, like how we study about metals normally, like that. Depending upon the application, lifetime, it's heat transfer capacity, all this based on that can go. And some shapes of metal nanoparticles, which is shown in the pic. So golden nanoparticles of various sizes and shapes, small and large, nanospheres, nanorods, sharpened nanorods. I showed you one pic about the different shapes of nanoparticles which are used. So here they have given the same details. Sharpened nanorods, nanoshells, nanocages, hollow nanosphere cubes, rhombic, octahedral, concave, tetrahedral, chromic tetrahedral, and the nanoprism, nanoprism. So there are different types. So it a nanoparticle is not having a particular shape. So current nano devices, nanosensor devices, talking, we have nanostructure materials, example porous silicon, where we use nanoparticles, nanoprobes, nanowires, nanosensors, nanosystem, cantilever, and NEMS. The porous silicon is one which is used much. So porous silicon is identical to the silicon used in many technologies application today, but its surface contains thin porous ranging from less than 2 nanometer to microns that can absorb and emit light. So this is a nanoparticle which is very much used in many sensors. A small brief history of this material, first reported in 1956, and a chemical etching. As I told you, in that format we can use it. Crystalline etch channels found in 1970s. Then further development came. Then we went for temperature sensing and things. And in 1990, the fluorescence, temperature fluorescence that came. So quantum technology and fluorescence, are just, they brought it. So there were much more development happening. So classification of this porous silicon is nanoporous silicon, mesoporous, macroporous, and porous generated by electrical breakdown. So you can see the size depending on the classification. Sorry. So mechanism, like if you tell normally, since we are talking about different types, There is like multiple mechanism by which recognition event can be like transduced into measurable signals. Generally, these take advantages of nanomaterials because they are very sensitive, rather than the normal sensor, the nano sensors, which uses nanomaterial. Very sensitive. Other unique property, you have this bounded analysis, so you can get a very clear detail when you analyze. And electrochemical nanosensors are based on detecting a resistance change in the nanomaterial. So whatever nanomaterials we go with, silicon based. So even when talking, many of these nanomaterials are used in small batteries, lithium battery and mobiles in places where they use this material, nanomaterial. And nano probes, so pebble probes they call, probe embedded by biological localized encapsulation. So sphere shaped use, the pH, calcium, magnesium, oxygen, potassium. So these are some materials used as nano probes. So this is one type of research diagram which is given by C.R. Johnson and team. So how they assemble the nanoparticles with the triangular plate, then they rotate the ball, they deposit on it, then film over the nanosphere. So it is nearing around 200 nanometer metal, which they have given so to manufacture a metal nanoparticle. So nanosphere lithography fabrication of nanoparticle arrays and film over nanosphere surface. This is one. And another less electrochemical, so I told nanosensors are based detecting resistance change. And the nanomaterial upon binding of analyte, due to the change in scattering or or to depletion or accumulation of charge carries. So the carbon nanotubes, conductive polymers or metal oxide nanowires as gates in field effect transistors been used. Chemical nanosensors, as I told you, we discussed what are the things. And coming under major type, which is more into mechanical, which is involved much under chemical. In nanosensors. So mechanical nanosensors identify moment, while chemical nanosensors test for chemical concentrations. So depending upon the application, we can select the nanosensors. So there is a big role of mechanical nanosensors also. The both nanosensors work by detecting change in electrical conductivity of material. So is watching movie in theater. So nanosensor detection limit for different surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy, LSPR. So some detection methods. So LSPR, they use nanomaterials like metal nanoparticles, silica nanoparticles enhanced with AU chromatic, normally used with gold nanoparticles and silver nanoparticles. The fluorescence used gold and quantum dots. Mechanical way, micro cantilevers, like we would have studied about cantilever beam in SM. The same concept of cantilever with the micro, like a nanostructure. Cantilevers, they use as sensors. Even a small change in temperature will give a cantilever effect, and we can use it as a sensing unit. And the suspended microchannel resonance. So talking about this microchannel, this is a very big research area, which deals with MEMS area. We know that cooling of processes, cooling of microchips, all this area, nowadays we need a microcooling system. So now the next is microcooling or nanocooling. So the heat exchangers, like heat removal devices, which you manufacture, is so complicated because we have to go like a nano manufacturing technology. So that area is also upcoming. The only problem is we have a lot of area to work, but the facilities depends upon the institution. So you have to check for that, especially in this area, nano area. We need the support. That is why I told, in case if anybody is interested, you can. There is a lab in Madurai Thyagaraj Engineering College. Other big institutions you have, since you have a reference, I'm just telling there. So you can check there and you can go with research. And this is a very good area. So you can directly decide that whether if you're interested, you can do research in this. And electrical silicon nanowires, nano ribbons, carbon nanotubes, graphene sheets, these are used in this electrical nanosensors. So the above table, the different transducers, principles, different way of detection and characteristics of the methods, including advantage and disadvantage. So basically, a sensor compromises of two central elements, a recognition element and a transduction element. So these are the main two things which we saw with above table, the materials which can be used. So furthermore, the transducer is linked to a readout system which transforms or amplifies the measured signal into understandable information for the user. So this is all the task which is done in the sensor. As I told you, the sensor takes the field to convert it. It gives us indication to the user. The transducer is linked to a readout system which transforms or amplifies the measured signal into understandable information for the user. So here, the samples, what type of test or what has to be done with the nano sensors, recognition elements deep which you're going to take. For example, they have told DNA, nanoparticles, bodies and things, which includes with the transducer. So electrochemical, optical, calorimeter, mass, magnetic, whatever type you have, which will be converted into a signal processing. So this processed signal, you will get it and you have to connect it to the required system and you can check what is the happenings there. So sensors, main element or recognition element and a transduction element. The sensor receives input from sample, which is converted into a signal. If recognition element is nanomaterial, at least one dimension is between 1 to 100 nanometer, we obtain a nano sensor. So totally the concept is same, only condition is with your nanomaterial which goes there. The nanomaterials which we saw in the above table. So depending upon the electrical and mechanical, that you can use the selected material. So electrochemical sensors can be used for numerous analysis. So electrical recognition is quickly expanding field with built up basics and minimal effort in the manufacturing procedure. The most common used nanomaterial is silica or nanowires because they possess high sensitivity and easy to functionalize or chemically modify on surface. Electrochemical detection approaches have different subtypes on the basis of signal type, like potentiometer, voltmeter, amperometer, and electrochemical impedance, spectroscopic. Sometimes electrochemical measurements are conjugated with immunoassays. The resulting sensors are called immunoassays. These categories depends on produced and amplified signal type. And there is also this biological nanosensors. So I think we'll be discussing with the bio nanosensors that I will see. So electrochemical sensors, the nanosensors based on detection of electrical signals. First and foremost, to report nano field effect transistors. In fact, we all would have studied field effect transistor. Based on that, possess tunable properties and can be responsible for EC and quantitative measurements. And the chemical nanosensors based FET principle utilizes rod-shaped nanomaterials or nanowires, nanorods, nanoribbons, nanotowers, and nanotubes. So these are used here when targeted analysis is clinging to the active area. This results in change of impedance and produces a signal. Nanomaterial with these morphologies provide increased sensitivity and active area for current flow compared to active across the cross section of other nanoscale. So morphologies on the flat detector surface. So optical nanosensors, signal detection by nanosensor provides high sensitivity as a result of the disintegrity of connection of active sites of nanomaterials with light signals. However, sensitivity is strongly depending on detection mode of optical phenomena. So optical sensors are used for several different types of spectrography analysis, like absorption, visible radiation, fluorescences, Raman effect, surface enhancement, Raman scattering, refraction, and qualitative analysis using dispersion. So an example of optical signal transducer is quenching of fluorescence by gold nanoparticles. So fluorescence from fluorescent isotolerance, FITC, that moves closely to gold nanoparticles is extremely quenched and no visible radiation signal is detected. The same molecule in close proximity to the nanoparticles exhibit increased Raman scattering signals, and that behaves like a Raman probe. So chemical or most sensors, graphic representation of gold nanoparticles interaction with fluorescent polymer. When the fluorescent polymer intermingles with the gold nanoparticles, the fluorescence is quenched. So when the targeted protein is here, we are checking for that, sensing that protein, attacks and displays the polymer, the fluorescence is restored. So this is the sensing unit which is acting in the nanosensor. So mechanical nanosensor. Mechanical nanosensors are made up of nanomaterials. Whenever a nanomaterial is physically manipulated, its electrically conductivity changes. So when mechanical movement or some physical movement is given, the sensor starts work. This changes invokes a response that can be measured using attached capacitor, because the physical change causes a quantitative change in capacitance. So that acts as a sensor. So mechanical detection system based on nanoparticles. So mechanical detection system based on nanoparticles allow ultra-sensitive detection and measure the changes in mechanical force at a molecular level. So nanomechanical sensors detect forces, displacements, and mass change. So the main advantage is the sensors are sensitive to mass. The property of measure and mass redundant themselves in itself, since various cases you can use it, nearly anything has a mass. So wherever we are going with this kind of force, display mass and things, nanomechanical sensors can be used. So determination of mass by mechanical device is directly related to overall device mass. Therefore, mass detection generally increases when the mass of mechanical sensor decreases to the nanoscale. So however, detection in fluid phase is a major obstacle for mechanical nanosensors. As a result, viscous damping, the sensitivity of sensor is critically reduced. So enclosing fluid-filled channels into a cantilever is one option to measure in fluids. So as I told you, the cantilever type, mechanical type sensors, even by using enclosing fluid fills, you can measure fluid things also, so you can sense it. So chemical nanosensors are also made up of nanomaterials. The electrical conductivity of the nanomaterial is reduced whenever a molecule absorbed to it. Chemical nanosensors test the electrical conductivity of nanomaterial and measure it whether they detect this change. Some example of chemical nanosensors include nanowires and nanotubes. And also I was telling you some chemical liquids which can be used for detection. So next coming, kind of cantilever based sensor. So here, nano cantilever based sensor have these things called cantilevers, one end affixed to the cantilevers, which stick out of the sensor like a tongue. So that tongue-like structure, which is away from the hold, nanoparticle. Okay, so even if there is a small change in temperature, even if there is some atoms or molecules which are present, it can sense it. It's such a small thing. So when the cantilever encounters different things, it will behave accordingly. If there is heat source, it will bend upward. If there is a surface tension, it will bend slightly. Pretty simple. So to collect data, scientists used benchmark and graphs for using this nano cantilever based sensors. So cantilever based sensors, so you can see here, the heat sensor, heat based mass sensor. So first surface stress. So the picture, you can see the movement of that tongue-like structure. So keeping that, we can sense it in a cantilever based sensing, which is used in a nano sensor. So label free measurements, low fabrication cost, mass production possible, high sensitivity. But anywhere, in any cases, when we go with any object or material or design or everything, so everywhere, depending upon the application, it changes. So that is the reason we have different materials and different things which has to be studied more. So photothermal sensors, electrostatic sensor, and magnetic sensor. So nano cantilever beam sensor is also used in the medical field, but instead they are called nano cantilever based biological sensors. All the same, even on, when we check normal nano sensor, they left it now in the sensors, nano sensors, which is used in medical field, they call it as nano biosensors. These detect and sense biomolecules. The resonant frequency of cantilever will change when it encounters certain molecules. As I told you, the same concept is used in normal cantilever sensor also. Molecular change, the things we do. So graphene sensor. So here, erythrodin vapor sensor. Okay, so normally, nowadays people start, we use real-time monitoring of certain things. So these are materials which are used in sensing even the sweat vapor or things. So backing electrodes are used. So small, even nowadays many people, we started using smartwatch, which has sensors, which can sense and give you the details of your heartbeat, how many steps you walk, which is all connected with all the sensors and all our nano sensors. And based upon the even temperature is measured. So there will be a temperature sensor, there will be a movement sensor, everything. Now you have it. So even this sensors, main application in robotics also, in path following robots. Normally, many robots, we program it. When you go with autonomous robots, mainly mingling with artificial intelligence, these sensors play a very big role because the input is totally given by them. So if it is pick and place, hand structure, each and every finger, you can keep a nano sensor. So based on that input, you can activate it. So there also they use much. So what is nano biosensor? Biosensor is a measurement system for the detection of an analyte that combines a biological component with a physicochemical detector and a nano biosensor. Is a biosensor that on the nano scale size. So Then the biosensors are used with nanotechnology, we call it as nanobiosensors. The concept and the working is almost same, transducer, detector, and biological recognition element, or receptors. So living biological system, cell, tissue, role, organs, antibody, enzymes, proteins, everything can be detected by using your nanobiosensors. So basic classification of your nanobiosensors. So nanobiosensors, as like our nanosensors, and they classify nanoparticle-based sensor, nanotube-based sensor, nanowire-based sensor. So this is some research article which is given. On that basis, I have taken this. So then they give, when you go with the nanoparticles, a magnetic biosensor, electrochemical or acoustic type biosensors are used. So everywhere, one thing keep in mind is when we talk about nano sensor, nanotechnology, everywhere, the very big concept is material, nanomaterials. So we have chances in developing new material, nanomaterials and structures. So please, researchers, those who are interested, can keep a mind on it. So here I want to share two technological video which is used in this. So actually, these videos are related to this nanotechnology in medical cancer, how it is having, because mechanically when we check, many videos are not available, so you can even check it once. You see this.
Imagine something 80,000 times smaller than the breadth of a ridge on a fingertip, unlocking a new frontier into cancer research. Nanotechnology, the science of building small, is changing the way we look at cancer. More importantly, the way we look at diagnosis and treatment. Nanotechnology allows researchers to build new tools that are actually smaller than cells, giving them the opportunity to attack cancer at the cellular and genetic level. This technology not only enables health practitioners to detect cancer earlier, but also holds the promise of stopping cancer before it even develops. This revolutionary approach is so precise, doctors will be able to design a unique treatment for an individual's own medical and genetic profile. Based on computer chip technology, diagnostic devices such as nanoarrays are thousands of times more sensitive and accurate than current techniques. Because of their size, multiple lab tests can be done more rapidly and at a much lower cost using one nano device instead of many. Nanoshells can be linked to antibodies that recognize tumor cells. Once they are taken up by the cancer cells, near-infrared light is applied, killing only the tumor and leaving neighboring, healthy cells intact. Scientists are engineering nanoparticles, such as dendrimers, to seek out and destroy cancer cells. This amazing technology can be customized for targeted drug delivery, improved imaging, and near real-time confirmation of cancer cell death. Moving research from bench to bedside is an important goal of the National Cancer Institute's Alliance for Nanotechnology in Cancer. A collaborative plan is underway to share research and development information across scientific disciplines and around the world. As biomedical applications of nanotechnology evolve, scientists are ensuring that nano devices are safe for both the body and the environment. The National Cancer Institute is optimistic that through coordinated and responsible development, nanotechnology will dramatically change cancer patient care. The science is at our fingertips.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, it's clear.
Visible, sir.
Okay. So now, like this, the nano sensor-based thing also much used in medical field and in micro mechanical parts. We use it. So coming here, what is 100 times stronger than steel, yet lighter than aluminium? You would have not seen much about this element. It is a carbon nanotube. Why I'm making more clear in this is, this area we have much more good research scope related to carbon nanotubes. We can use it for many cases, especially in nanosensors. For many cases, they use this. So nanotubes are among the strongest material ever discovered yet. Engineers are only just starting to unlock their full potential. So nanotube structure. Nanotube is a nanometer scale tube-like structure. It may refer to carbon nanotube, silicon nanotube, boron nitrate nanotube, inorganic nanotube, DNA nanotube, or membrane nanotube. So the size, if you see, it is 2.25 nanometer diameter and the 0.38 meter length. So there are some different types. So carbon nanotube production exceeds several thousand tons per year, actually. Why I'm telling this, such movement of this is there, used for applications in energy storage, device modeling, automotive parts, bottles, sporting goods, water filters, thin film electronics, coating, actuators, and electromagnetic shields. So these has such a good potential. Nano sensors much use this. Carbon nanotubes are all allotrope of carbon, meaning that they are one of the several possible arrangements of atoms that carbon can take. In nature, pure carbon is found either in form of graphite or soft flaky solid or diamond, which is transparent and the hardest natural occurring material. Carbon nanotubes are most closely related to graphite than diamond. So though graphite is very soft, it is constructed of layers of carbon atoms arranged in sheets on one atom thick. These individual sheets are called graphenes and carbon nanotubes, where or what you would get from rolling a graphene sheet into a shape of a tube. So called carbon tube. So here is your picture of how it is done. So nano diamond or nano tube or graphenes. So depending upon the carbon chain which you create and when you do, so you get that carbon nanotubes, nano diamonds, homophorous carbon, graphene, polycycle thing, carbon chains. So depending upon the requirement, we can design it. So coming under here, MIT engineers, what is MIT? Not Madras Institute of Technology. Anyone tell me? So it's Manchester's Institute of Technology. The engineers have built a modern microprocessor from this carbon nanotube. So field effect transistor pictured, which are seen as faster and greener than silicon transistors, the new approach. So when these kind of development is happening, now the sensor, the nano sensor, the requirement or the nano sensors application will also change when we create more modern materials and modern circuits. So the new approach uses the same fabrication process used for silicon chip. So because when we go with this nanoparticles, one more limitation is that manufacturing of nano sensors or manufacturing of nano devices. The schematic summary of kinds of quasi one-dimensional metal oxides, nanostructures are given here. So if it is a nanowire A, the structure will be like that, which can be easily used in sensors. And so I'm showing this is, so depending upon the requirement of the application of your sensor, the nanosensors. You can go with the different types of shapes of material, shapes, different types of material. So it is according to the application where we are going to design the nano sensor. Applications, as we know, there are a number of applications we have already seen. So almost in defense and military, now they are very much using nanotechnology, especially nanoscience. So there also it is very much applied. So sensor, as I told you, nano sensor in places of even detecting landmines, bombs, based on for that also we use. Or even flying sensors, like which I showed you, some small fly like thing, you can keep a nano sensor fixed with a small micro nano technology totally, which goes and even you can detect that. So the development is coming up there. So here there are different shapes and things based upon our requirement of sensor design, we can select it. So B is your core shell structure with a metallic inner core, semiconductor or metal oxide. C, nanotubes, nanopipes, and hollow nanorods. And D are heterostructures. E is nano belt or nano ribbons. F is nanotapes. G is dendrites. And H is helically nanostructures. And I is nanosphere assembly. And J is nanosprings. So even nanosprings are there based on the spring effect. You can convert it. You can keep it in the sensor. Using that, you can convert the signals. You can process the signal and you can sense it. So from morning up to now, we have seen certain things. I'm just giving a small recall, not much. So what all we have seen is what actually we saw, and hope you people will learn the concept of that. Hello, can you? Actually, it was plugged in some other, I would have connected with the generator point. Okay. So here from morning up to now, we have seen about the details of nanosensors, material, how they manufacture, what are the application of that, and main materials which can be done mechanically, what all types we have. So after looking all this, at least I believe that we'll understand this concept. So what is nano? What is a nanometer? What is nanotechnology? We saw the concept of that little history. We just brought it for remembrance, applications of that. What is normally sensor is, and what is the importance of nanosensor, its working type and applications. So we saw a little about nanostructure geometries, what is nanoelectronics we saw, and use of nanosensors, types of nanosensors, nanomaterials, a nanosensor device, and nanosensor fabrication, and nanobiosensor we just have a glance. And the type of nanobiosensors we had, and the carbon nanotubes I lastly discussed. So coming under there, so total recall, we can take like this: type of nanosensors, physical, deformation of sensors, mass pressure force, chemical, detection of molecules, composition and concentration, biological, detection of protein, and this electrochemical detectors, optical transducers. So this all we recall. So now coming into the development, research and development in this nano sensors. So happy to see that IIC, Indian Institute of Science. So here they have developed a highly sensitive, low cost nano sensor that can quickly detect minute changes in carbon monoxide level. So with potential application in environmental pollution monitoring. So this is the latest thing which has happened in IIC, Indian Institute of Science. The new sensor developed at UC Berkeley can be made into smart wristband or headbands that provide a continuous real-time analysis and the chemicals in the sweat. So even can read the sweat and it can give you the details. So user wearing the flexible sensor array can run and move freely while the chemicals in their sweat are measured and analyzed. The resulting data, which is transmitted wireless to a mobile device, can be used to help assess and monitor user state the health. So now this was actually, I was telling, this is little more, already we have the smart watch and wristband, we have little more making using of nano sensors. So this flexibility, bringing the flex, because the advantage in nano sensor is the sensor is going to be very thin and small. So flexibility, bringing flexibility to that is more easy. So just imagine if you're living a nano sensor, you know, inside your body, where you have to sense something. So if it is having such a good flexibility, it won't spoil your veins or thing. So it will cope up with and go. So nanotechnology, the one more thing, a very big thing, as I told you, is it will be very much used in human health, especially in checking and doing things. Even in future, like you can take nano particles, like which will be like sensors. You can drink it; they'll steady inside and come out as outlet. So the technology may be like this in future. It will be happening. So, for example, some companies, nano sensors, which they manufacture, the P23, just a gas odor sensing, which can be kept in all places. Even sensing, for example, in ACs, small compact AC area, also you can use these nano sensors. If there is leakages, it will detect and give you. So coming into good research, what is happening at present in nano sensor and nano field. So engineers imagining new possibilities in manufacturing, fluid mechanics, robotics, combustion, biomedicine, measurements, heat transfer, and all more. With these tools, mechanical engineers conduct world-class research in nanoscale manufacturing and micro and nano fluidics. So research is going not only in this little bit, which I'm just giving an idea. So there is, if you go and check, there are small area which they do some research in nanotechnology. So nano sensors are the latest detection technology, driving convenience, robustness, the portability of pollutant analysis, many sectors, including air and water quality measurement, food analysis, strategic purpose, and quality control assessments. So these areas also full, they use nano sensors in the research area. So apparent sensors, so this is also a type of nano sensor, have shown excessive assurance in protein sensing with the high sensitivity, selectivity, and low cost. So sensitivity and specific potassium nano sensors. So now, as I was telling, the materials which we saw in nano sensors are the top materials normally used with top nano sensors. So even now they go with some next level of reducing the cost and the things. They do a lot of research based on the materials which are used in nano sensors. Because in the past we saw that the present nano sensors, which is working with gold, the silver, titanium oxide. So these all includes more cost. So material selection for these has to be done. So first for that, we have to know how we are going to generate, how we are going to manufacture our methods and things. So based on that, we have to again go with further study on material. Then we have to check. So the easiest way, even many people, they do flow analysis. Analysis of cooling, microchannel coolings they do. So there, everywhere in that fluid, we mix nanoparticles. Normally, even in solar and many IC engines, everywhere now we are trying for that cooling system with the nanoparticles. So which carries the transfers the heat. So that kind of nanoparticles, if they are able to sense, automatically it can be even used in nanosensors. So the sensing material, sensing unit has to be developed or designed with low cost and things, which again we can go on. But main problem is the manufacturing. So concern manufacturing area, we have to find it out for doing research. That is one problem, because you need that nanotechnological machines to manufacture them. And intelligent packing system. So in food industries and in industries, normally when they go with the packing, they use sensors and nanosensors to monitor food quality and safety. So in this area, based on industry, or based on the food product, or based on the product, we can do a research. What type of sensors can be used? What type of nanosensors, with which combination it can be used? So that is a research which is going at present. So these all, what I'm telling is the present going research work. So you can also just check, and you can also find somewhere where you can work. So food quality and safety, you can do that. So SWNT based nanosensors for wireless detection of explosive and the chemical warfare agents. So this, already I was telling, in defense they started doing a lot. So here also, in this area also, they do a lot of research using, based on nanosensor. So electromagnetic wireless nanosensors and the networks. So now, one more interesting thing what they started is, networking is also done with the nanotechnology. So nanosensors, one part. Away from that, the total system also, they're planning for nanoparts. And with the nanosensor, they do the system. So graphene-based nanosensors and a smart food packing system for food safety and quality monitoring. So this graphene-based nanosensors research area with food safety, the nanosensors play a big role. So you can check for that area for some research. A development of two-dimensional transition metal dichocolagon based nanosensor platforms. So in this area, now they do a lot of research related to that. Next, carbon based nanomaterials for development of sensitive nanosensor platform. So we saw that carbon, normally when classified or the combination changed, we have graphite, we have carbon nanotubes. So everywhere you can make modifications in that, and improving the sensitivity, reducing the cost, giving the better accuracy. So these are the platforms where you can work with carbon-based nanosensors. So advanced nanomaterials for inexpensive gas microsensors and the nanosensors. So this area, the nanomaterial, as I told you, advanced nanomaterials for inexpensive gas microsensors. So gas microsensors, normally in, here in India, it is little less, but in foreign countries, we know in many places, the safety is very important. So they're nearing in many houses and places, this fire sensors, gas sensors and all are fixed. So especially in fire sensor and things, there will be an immediate change in temperature or things where you can sense it easily. When we talk about this gas molecules, if we are there, we may get some smell or something. If nobody is there, the sensing, the nanosensor can even sense that molecules, and it can give you. So, but the cost effectiveness on that, as I told you, changing with the different types of methods, or changing the nanosensor with the materials, or with the mechanical or electrical, or what type of device you're using, in that you can do research using advanced nanomaterials. So semiconductor nanocrystal. So next part of research which is going much is in semiconductor nanocrystals. So which are used in sensing, in nanosensors. And so this semiconductor nanocrystal based nanosensors and the metal ion sensing. So here also a lot of research which is going in with the semi. When we start any research, I think, so first you can just go with the normal sensor and things. Related to that, we can check with nanoparticles, which is available. For example, normal sensors in our lab we have. In colleges, we will be having some sensors. So you can cross-check with that. And you can further study with nanomaterials. And nanomaterials, in the sense, even normally our materials which we do for our research work and things, whether that can be converted into nanoparticle. So because normally the people who much involved with nanoparticle, if we give that material, they may use it and they may do the sensor, but the person who is doing a sensor will not come for the particle. So what is available, they do. So when, as being in engineering and research, it is not that we have to design a nano sensor, as I told you. It can be a material, it can be a design, it can be how you manufacture. So everywhere you can prove your research skills. So antibody nano sensors, which has to be very perfectly done for bio sensors. So there a lot of research is going on. Nano sensors in environmental analysis. So now normally we use sensors. So for example, if you go to bigger cities, we would have heard this term called footprints. So there normally we use general sensors, which is not very accurate. We give some readings. So depending upon the carbon dioxide left there. So even after getting that input, the vehicles are stopped in that particular area for some time to reduce the footprints. So when we go for nano sensors, many cases we can fix it in this applications. So that is only keeping applications of nano sensors, you can go with research work. And so environmental analysis based on nano sensors, there is a research going on. Integration of nano sensors into a sealed micro channel in hybrid. So micro channels and hybrid chip devices, cooling and a nano sensor. So normally to find out, check out what is the performance of it, researchers are doing research in that. And nano sensors for trace explosive detection. We use nano sensors. Research is going in that area. A selective nano sensor device for exhaled breath analysis. So breath analysis, as I told you, this is very interesting in nano sensors. Even when you breathe, the nanoparticles which is present in the air which you live, it can be measured. So that analysis do better equipments for treating human. So next they're telling about this alpha, beta, gamma and following sections were fabricated by using spin coating and AU deposition technology. So talking here in nanotechnology, we saw some brief and certain technologies which were used for manufacturing things. So in that also research is going on. You can change the method of manufacturing that. So here coming alpha, used AU film and 30 nanometer of AU sheets. And the beta, so this is one type of research. So the problem I am telling here is some cases, even in nanotechnology, totally practically, if you are not able to do, at least we can frame at what type we are going to do, what we are going to do. Theoretically, even you can do some work with this nanotechnology so that our next development will be there. Once we come to get some practical guidance, so we can go further. So theoretically, if you go through some literatures, which in area which you are interested, for example, nano in robotics or nano in gas nanosensor or bio nanosensor, whatever type you require. So if you internally go and study around 50-60 articles, you will get a better idea how even theoretically you can decide what type of things you can do. So multimodal nanosensor. So here, the schematic of multimodal sensing platform. So here, this is transverse electric mode detector, transverse magnetic mode detector, and phase shifter advance. So all put together, so that is called as multimodal nanosensors. So which can have multiple work, which can do multiple work. So intensity, wavelength, polarization, everything can be checked. So metal oxide nanosensor, crystal for sensing. So here they're doing a lot of research, the chemical and physical property of this metal oxides can be done, sensitive to change their chemical environment, the sensitive property, semiconductor based, I told you, metal oxides, nano builds, nano wires. So these areas, this nano, for example, if you take nano wires, in what material it is there any other possibilities to change it, that you can make a study and make your research. So based on built nano wires and nano ribbons, you can make it. And study of nano devices and application based, you can do. Because normally when we talk about nanotechnology, it's a bit difficult for practical things. You can try with it. So applications in micro manufacturing, biological injection, and nanosensor assembly. So a lot of research scopes are in this micro manufacturing. The biological injections, they do a lot. Nanosensor assembly, self-powered nanosensors. Now they are trying for this, the self-powered nanosensors. Massive research is going on, not much outputs are given much. So it is all justification research works, which is going on in self-powered nanosensors. So commonly in nanosensors and nanomaterials, mass research is going on. Nanosensors for space applications, NASA, including NASA. Lot of research is going in space application. So that is another area where you check. So these are some more research which have been done with CNT based nanosensors. So here you can see the difference of what they show in making the research in nanotechnology. So systems, single wall nanotubes were used. The target is NH3 and NO2. So silent features is sensitive to, so up to which ppm and what all the things they can do. So it was done in 2002. So like this, single wall nanotubes, they were used for gas concentration things. Multi-wall gas concentration, polyamine, 9 times increases the sensitivity. So based on this, I'm giving an example. Like when we go with literatures, so we get more ideas. So interchanging these nano technology or nano materials or some nano sensor changing, so you can make a combination and we can go with the research work in this. So sensor response time, based on that they do, and glucose solutions they check, that proteinism they do. The almost, and these are some research areas which they work much. And oxide based nanosensors, which are used in particular research areas like this, just go through nothing, just I'm giving an idea like how and what all topics you can check with. But commonly checking facilities is one problem which we have, because even in nano, one more problem is the materials are not much available in our market. So getting this nano materials is also a bit difficult, because last year we tried for one project related to nano material, which was mixed for cooling purpose of IC engine. So actually we decided to buy some particular nanometals, but we couldn't buy it. So we went with some other nanometals. So that is one issue here. But anyway, we can try. So from MEMS to NEMS, micro electromechanical systems. So here in mechanical field, when you come here, so based on this micro electromechanical systems, we can go with lots of study with nanosensors. Surely we will be using a lot of input data which is required from the micromechanical systems and there. You can use this nanosensors, which will be very effective. So based on the data which you require. So NEMS, nano electromechanical system or structures. There, in this both areas, mixing nanotechnology, already nanotechnology is there. I'm telling for research purpose. So these two areas are a very good area where we can work with. So that is what, when you come to the application or the final application. So even in the latest automated AV car, autonomous car, we need this technology. Robotics, we need the technology. Mechatronics is there. We need this nanotechnology. When we go with coming up developments. So process such as electron beam lithography and the nano machining now enables semiconductor nanostructure to be fabricated below 10 nanometer. It would appear that the technology exists to be built in NEMS, nano electromechanical systems. So nano electromechanical systems and micro electromechanical system also, at least we know a little. So now upcoming is nano electromechanical system. Everywhere it will be nano sensors, nano devices inside the system. So this area, it is where we can find a research topic to do it. Challenges for NEMS, communicating signal from nanoscale to microscope world. So that is our problem. Understanding and controlling microscopic mechanism, the problem. Developing method for reproducible and routine nano fabrication, the problem. So here all we can do research. So last conclusion, existing nano sensors have realistic applications. Current generation nano sensors are still based on micro sensing, not too much into nano sensing. Technique that are enhanced or miniature. Factor nano sensor will create chronic shifts, enabling nanotechnology, and future nano sensors will be possible with development of nano electronics and interoperable nano devices. Nano sensors will ultimately have an enormous impact on our ability to enhance energy conversion, control pollution, produce food, and improve human health and longevity. So I would like to conclude with this. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor, for a valuable session. Candidates, if you have any queries, you can have a couple of minutes. Or at the end of the Friday program, sharing each and every resource person's email ID, you can ask them also in person if you have any queries later on. So let's conclude the session for today. So first, I would like to thank Professor M. Babu, the Dean of Mechanical Engineering Department, Narasimha Reddy College, Telangana. Thank you very much for your valuable session, sir. It was very useful for us. And in the chat box also, you would have received many positive messages. Your session was very, very useful for us, sir. Thank you very much. I thank all the participants, faculty members, research colleagues, and the PG students for patiently attending the program and being the first day, making it a very successful one. I thank you once and all. Tomorrow morning, the session will begin at 9:30 a.m. So all candidates are asked to be present in the prompt time. So we shall end the session for now. Thank you, everybody, once again. We'll meet tomorrow morning. Thank you. Bobu sir, thank you very much.
No, thank you, Mr. Sachin. Thank you for the opportunity.
You're most welcome, sir. Participants, the session is adjourned and now you can leave. Thank you very much. I hope you all have filled the feedback form. The link has been posted. Kindly do it without fail. Thank you very much.